Welcome to the Vitamin Chica YouTube channel. My name is Lynette, and I created this channel to share health and wellness information with all of you. And to help other people find this channel too, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. This really will help everyone get this great information, because I understand in our busy lives, sometimes our health gets put on the back burner. That's why I want to talk about this topic, salt. We don't really think about salt on a daily basis. Do you ever just say, oh, I'm not gonna have that pizza because I've already reached my limit on sodium today? We don't have no idea how much sodium we're taking in every day. But that's why we're gonna talk about it today. And I'm gonna talk about all the different types of salt, like the difference between sea salt, kosher salt, table salt, whether you should have iodized salt or non-iodized salt. There are other salts out there like smoked salt or flake salt, but I'm gonna stick to the most commonly used salts and talk about the pros and cons and talk about how they impact your health. When we talk about salt and our health, what we're really talking about is the amount of sodium. The chemical name for salt is actually sodium chloride, so that's why we're taking in the sodium. But sodium is not bad. We really need it to help our muscles and our nerves work properly. We need it to control our blood pressure, but moderation is definitely key. And in the eyes of the FDA, moderation is staying under 2,300 milligrams of sodium per day. But researchers have found that we really only need 500 milligrams of sodium per day to keep our muscles, nerves, and blood pressure working properly. Americans right now, on average, are having 3,400 milligrams of sodium per day, and most of that sodium is coming from salt. 90% is coming from the salt they intake every day. When you have too much salt, your kidneys, they just can't keep up with all the extra sodium you're putting in your body. And this triggers your body to hold on to more water. And when that happens, you get more blood volume. You get like more blood in your system. And then all this blood has to flow through those same blood vessels, creating pressure. And that's why you get high blood pressure. Not only that, it puts a strain on your heart because now your heart has to pump around all this extra blood. And that's why you're at a high risk for heart attacks, for strokes, and for high blood pressure. But over time, this can get even more serious. If you keep having more and more salt, then the blood vessels start to stiffen, and also your heart can get damaged and your kidneys can get damaged. But it doesn't have to be like this, because as soon as you hear your doctor tell you you have high blood pressure, you can change your diet to a low sodium diet and reverse these issues of having high blood pressure and this extra blood volume causing all these issues. Avoiding sodium is easier than you think, and it's better to start reducing your sodium intake before your body starts giving you those warning signs like high blood pressure. Most of the sodium that we intake comes from processed foods or from eating out at restaurants. That's because salt is used as a preservative to help the food last longer. Let's look at these 10 different foods that we commonly eat and have high levels of sodium. They are bread, cold cuts, pizza, canned soups, chicken, meat dishes like meatloaf or chili, pasta more because of the sauce, snacks like popcorn and pretzels. One of the most common examples to show how much sodium we're ingesting and not even realizing is the sandwich example. So let's look at the sandwich example. And as you can see, it's about 1500 milligrams of sodium. And that's three times as much sodium as we actually need in a day, and more than half of what the FDA recommends as the upper limit of sodium. Another misconception is that one salt is healthier than another salt. They do have their differences, but no matter what salt you use, you're still putting sodium in your body. One of the most popular that's been touted to be super healthy is sea salt. You can see tons of products that have sea salt, made with sea salt, added sea salt on their front panel to try to make you think that this is a healthier option. Well, the trend started because more and more people want to eat less processed foods. And sea salt is less processed, because regular table salt goes through a lot of processes because it is mined, and after it's mined, then it goes through a process to get rid of all the minerals. Then some salt also add an additive to help the salt from not clumping, and then sometimes they add iodine onto that salt as well. But with sea salt, it's just evaporated from ocean water or salted lakes. And depending on the region, it has all the trace minerals from that region. Also, depending on the region, is where you get the colors. That's why you get pink sea salt, blue sea salt, black sea salt. It's just based on what body of water the sea salt was evaporated from. I also was curious, why did they decide to add iodine to table salt? And what I found was it was to help with thyroid function. But there's a lot of natural ways to get iodine in your diet. You can get it from eggs or seafood. And some people, they don't need the extra iodine. Like people that have an overactive thyroid, which is called hyperthyroidism, actually having more iodine makes their condition worse. So if you want a product that definitely doesn't have iodine, you should look at kosher salt. So kosher salt does not mean that a rabbi blessed the salt. It just means that the salt actually has a larger granule or bigger crystals. So let's say a recipe says you need 1/4 teaspoon of salt. If you use kosher salt, you would fill it up and it would be technically less sodium than if you did 1/4 teaspoon of table salt. So the goal is really to get less sodium. So if you have to trick yourself into using kosher salt with the larger granules to get less sodium, then do that. But if you're gonna use 1/4 teaspoon of kosher salt and say it's not salty enough and add more, then you're defeating the purpose. I hope you found this week's video on salt and sodium intake interesting. As you can see, small adjustments to your diet can have a big impact on your health. So why not reduce your sodium intake? It could prevent you from having high blood pressure or long-term kidney or heart issues. You know what the saying says, you are what you eat. And all I want is for all of us to have health and happiness. And that's it from me, the Vitamin Chica.